Please tell me that you didn't forget my blueberry muffin.
Hi.
Lois will be back in a few minutes. She and Ned went up to the house to have breakfast with Emily. She's back.
Lucky too?
Yeah, last night.
Good. That's good. That's real good.
Yeah.
Where are you going?
I'm going to the studio, and you're free to wait here. I'll stay out of your way.
Brenda, wait.
That's what we agreed on, right?
The usual rules don't apply.
Not when it comes to Stone, but otherwise I think we should stick with the plan. Like you said the other night, we're dealing with enough.
Well, now there's more.
Stone?
There's no easy way to say this. Robin's HIV positive.
No, she's not. No, she is not. No, she's not.
Take care, Robin.
No, not Robin.
Oh, sweet.
Wait. I'm sorry if I'm making this difficult for you.
Heck, it's not about me, Brenda.
Thank you for coming and telling me this yourself. It would have been so much worse coming from somebody else.
I guess that's what Robin figured.
Oh,
wait. Don't start imagining stuff, because it doesn't have to be like it was for Stone. Robin doesn't have age yet. She'll take care of herself. She could be okay for years. She's got it. She's got a great attitude, and that's important because she believes she'll live a long time.
She does.
You know what she said? That there are people who have lived with this almost as long as she's lived already. If she can hang on to that,
Robin is HIV positive. That's the way it is. This is the worst possible time for this to happen. Because she wanted more than anything for Stone to be able to die knowing that she was going to be okay. Does he have to know?
She said there has never been a lie between them, and she doesn't want to start now.
She just keeps getting stronger and braver.
And the children shall lead them.
All right. Do you think that Robin asked you to come over here and tell me this because she doesn't want to see me right now?
No, I don't think that was the reason.
Okay, good, because I just need to go over there. I need to get my head together before I go over there. Robin is okay today. She's going to be okay tomorrow, right? Right? I mean, that's as much guarantee as anybody can ask for right now, right?
Yeah.
So I'm just going to go over there and see her like I always do. And she just, it's, I mean, it's not she's going to look any different. She's just the same. She's beautiful and she's so strong. A lot stronger than I am. Oh, my God. Robin? No, I don't want to accept this.
I know.
No, I can't. I mean, it's not supposed to be this way. It's not fair. I mean, she's good and she's decent. She's full of love. She did everything right, except miscalculate the risks of unprotected sex, but she... She's got to pay for that with her life.
You said HIV positive, not AIDS.
Right. She still has lots of time.
We can help her make the most of it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We better believe it. We're all in this together.
Yeah.
So, what can we do right now?
Robin doesn't want Stone to blame himself.
This can't be about blame because Stone and Robin, they always showed us the very best that we could be. So, you know, we can't let that get lost.
Thanks. All right, I'm gonna, I gotta go check in at the club and then I gotta go back to the penthouse. So you guys got each other. It's not a good time to be alone.
Remember that.
You do the same.
Robin has more fight in her than most of us. And I'm sure she's going to give it her best shot. For Stone's sake, as well as her own. But you're right. There is the making of a real tragedy in all this. If you misinterpret the compassion that Sonny feels for Stone and Robin as a basic change in the man, you're asking for real trouble.
Back off, Ned! Robin asked Sonny to come over here and give me the test results.
It's not about Robin.
What are you talking about? It's all about Robin. And about Stone. And if you can't muster up any compassion for Sonny under these circumstances, then why don't you just keep your mouth shut?
Look, we have all been shut out by this.
I just found out that one of my oldest, closest friends is walking around with a potentially deadly virus in her system. Sonny understood that. Because he's hurting too. And all you can think about is that Sonny might be scheming against you? I have big news for you, Ned. Sonny has more important things on his mind.
Look at the way you're defending.
Listen, Sonny deserves some common sympathy right now. Can you agree with me on that? Common, decent sympathy.
Of course. And I am sorry for Stone. And Lord knows I am sorry about Robin.
Then let's just leave it at that for now, okay?
Brenda, I don't want...
I am going to see Robin.
Okay.
Yes, Sonny will be there, Ned, so just get over it.
I guess I blew that.
He's not that bad.
Well, I'm sorry, but I'm just not a paid-up member to the Sonny Corinthos fan club.
Okay. He has had some questionable business dealings, but the man has feelings.
Feelings of jealousy and paranoia that make him dangerous.
He cares. Look at what he's done for Stone, and look at what he's done for Robin.
His care Caring almost got Brenda shot up in a shower.
No, why are we arguing about this?
Because I see you, and I see Brenda being sucked back in by Sonny's enigmatic charm.
It's not his charm. He's a complicated man. Look, what can I say? I mean, once you love Sonny Corinthos, you just don't stop loving him.
Well, his joint is still standing. How goes it?
Not good.
Stone?
He slipping away. Anyway, welcome back, buddy. How you doing? I heard the kids are home. How'd you find them?
Well, actually, I didn't. They sort of doubled around on their own, and... Well, it's a long story, but the point is everybody's in good shape.
Glad to hear it.
There was some interesting fallout.
Is Laura okay?
Laura is better than okay. Laura's better than she's been in a long, long time. And me too. As a matter of fact, you can hang the for rent sign. I'm leaving the apartment. I'm moving back home.
It's about time.
Yeah. Sorry to have to dump all this responsibility on your shoulders at this point.
Oh, hey, no sweat, you know. Got me going.
You look all out of gas, man.
Yeah, I am. Damn, I didn't... I hate to have to bring you down, but there's something you need to hear from me before you hear from somebody else. Stone made Robin get tested again so he would know. She's HIV positive, man.